understanding is.
Yes, we are going to look at formula of compounds. Formula of what? Compound. In the previous calculation we did, we solved for potassium heptaozodichromate 6, isn't it?
Yes.
Instead of writing this as potassium heptaozodichromate 6, it's very long, is it not? We can simply write it as K2Cr2O7, isn't it? This is the chemical formula. This is the chemical what? Formula of potassium heptaozodichromate what? 6. So it's a sign for writing chemicals so that you don't have to write it very long. Is that clear? But you need to understand how these formulas come about, how you can write it. Because somebody might want to write this and say KCrO2. You see, but you're still having potassium, chromium, and what? Oxygen. But it's not writing it very well. So how do you come about writing the right, getting the right sign or the right chemical formula? We say that chemical formula is a sign to represent the what? Molecules of elements and compound and comprises of combination of what? Symbols. Chemical formula comprises the combination of what? Symbols. Can you see the symbols? This is the symbol for potassium, is it not? This is the symbol for chromium, and this is the symbol for what? Oxygen. So when you combine symbols like this, you have what you call what? Chemical what? Formula. Chemical formula is a sign to represent molecules of elements and what? Compound. And it comprises of combination of what? Symbols. How do you come about the right symbol? Number one, you must have it in mind that you must understand the concept of atomicity. You must understand the concept of what? Atomicity. How do atoms of some elements, how do they exist naturally? You find out that atoms of elements, these are known as the noble gases, is it not? Helium, neon, and what? Argon. All the atoms can exist as a monoatom. Is that clear? They are what? Monoatomic. They can exist as one. And that's why you can write it as this, He, without adding 2 or 3. Ne, without adding 2, 3, 4. You understand? Argon. So you find out that most of the noble gases exist as what? Monoatom. They are what? Monoatomic. They exist with the atomicity of what? 1. In their molecules, only one atom that is in their molecule. Is that clear? But you find out that most of the halogens and non-metals, most of the what? Halogens and non-metal exist as what? Diatoms. The atomicity is 2. They exist as 2 atoms in one of their molecules. Is that clear? Have you ever seen oxygen written like this in chemical formula? You normally see oxygen written as O2, is it not? O2, because there are 2 atoms of oxygen inside one molecule. Is that clear? O2 simply means what? O2 means one molecule of what? Oxygen. But it's having how many atoms? 2 atoms. Is that clear? And that's how nitrogen, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, and iodine, most of the non-metals. Is that clear? Now you find out that we also have triatomic molecules like ozonized oxygen. Then we have polyatomic like this form of sulfur and potassium. Is that clear? So you must have this at the back of your mind for you to understand how to write formula of chemical compounds. How to write what? Formula of chemical compound. You need to understand the atomicity. And atomicity simply means the number of atoms in each molecule of an element. Atomicity is what?
Number of atoms
in each what? Molecule. So these are molecules of these various elements. What is the number of atoms in helium molecule? What is the number of atoms in nitrogen molecule? What is the number of atoms in ozone molecule? Is that clear? And that is also the atomicity. Is that clear? Now we're going to look at another concept that is very similar to atomicity, and that is relative atomic mass. That is what?
Relative atomic mass.
relative atomic mass. Please write along. Relative atomic mass is defined as the number of times one atom of an element is as heavy as is the number of times one atom of an element is as heavy as is as heavy as one atom of hydrogen. One atom of hydrogen. Exactly. We use mass spectrometer to determine relative atomic mass. It is determined using a mass spectrometer. So how do we get this relative atomic mass? So we're going to look at some elements and their relative atomic masses. Elements relative atomic mass. So let's look at some elements and their relative atomic mass. Hydrogen has the relative atomic mass of 1.1. Helium has that of 4.0. Helium has that of 4.0. Is that clear? Lithium has that of 6.0. Lithium has that of 6.0. Beryllium has that of 9.0. Beryllium has 9.0. And boron has 11. Carbon has 12. Is that clear? And nitrogen has 14. Nitrogen has 14. Oxygen has 16, fluorine 19, neon 20, and sodium 23. Is that clear? Please, what do you understand? What is the relationship between this relative atomic mass and which of the numbers that we said that is very close to relative atomic mass? Mass number, isn't it? So you see, it's the same thing I'm saying, the mass number. Relative atomic mass is close to, it's approximately the mass number. It's approximately the what? Mass number. So if somebody asks you what is the relative atomic mass of a given element, how do you get it? Since you know the atomic number, do you know the atomic number of the first 20 elements? So you simply say how many, what times what? 2 times the number, is it not? Because 2 times the number is the mass number, is it not? And mass number is almost approximately the same thing as relative atomic mass. But the definition says that was relative atomic mass is the number of times one atom of an element is as heavy as one atom of what? Hydrogen. You understand? It's a relative mass that we're using in quantifying elements in chemistry. Is that clear? In relation to hydrogen.